Hi everyone and welcome back, it's Vicky here with 4 traditional cards today, showcasing products from the latest release by Pink Fresh Studios. I'm going to show you some of the stamps and dies that have been released, and for every one of those stamps and dies I will share a card today. So let's start with that wreath stamp set. This one is called Season Greetings. You get the wreath as well as a bow and many sentiments that you can play with. Notice that the matching dies are not connected, so you can cut out only the inside, the outside, or use them both. This stamp set is called Sparkle with Magic. It gives you lots and lots of bits and pieces to create your own background, as well as a lovely frame that you can stamp. You can see an example at the back. You can mix and match all those elements to create your very own backgrounds. Now here is another background, this one is connected, and it is great if you want to mass produce some cards. All you have to do is to just stamp that and maybe color it in or leave it as it is. And this one is called Cozy Christmas Wishes. Moving on to the dies, this is a die set which is called Layered Wreath. It gives you not only the wreath parts but also some extra leaves that you can cut out to layer on top, as well as flowers and little circles. So you can use this die set all year round, for Christmas as well as for any other season. And this is the classic Holiday Words die set. You get many sentiments in here for your Christmas cards. And you get the actual world as well as the outline. Now I'm going to share today 4 cards using all of these products so you can see them in action. And I'm starting with this wreath die. All the cards that I will be sharing today are going to be in the Christmas traditional colors, just because I love this color combo. So here I'm preparing everything to die cut, and I'm playing with a couple of shades of green. And I will use the green glitter cardstock to cut out all those little berries. And here is the die that cuts out flowers, so it doesn't have to be a Christmas wreath. Anyway, I'm going to put those aside and start building my wreath. This is going to have quite a lot of dimension, so I'm going to play with the little cutouts and I'm going to spread them around my wreath. Once I place them all around my wreath and decide where everything is going to go, I'm going to stick them down with my glue. For that I'm using my Nouveau Deluxe, and I'm also using this wax pencil that helps me pick up all those tiny little pieces. And once all the leaves are down, I'm going to add a few dots of glue here and there so that I can stick on top my tiny little berries. Now if you want, you can skip this step, and instead of cutting out all those little dots and stick them down, you can always use your Nouveau drops or your stickles. Nouveau Deluxe dries completely clear, so even if you can see some of it behind those berries, it's not going to show at the end. So here is how the wreath is looking at the moment. You can make it more dimensional if you want by curling up some of those leaves. And when I was sticking down all those light green leaves, I made sure that I added glue only at the bottom of each of those leaves so that I can lift them easily now. The wreath looks awesome as it is, but I'm going to show you that you can take it a step further and make it even fuller and fluffier. So I cut out one more wreath out of that light green cardstock. I'm giving it a little bit of a curl there so that it is dimensional, and then I'm going to stick one on top of the other. And remember, this can be a wreath for any season, depending on what you choose to stick on top of those leaves. For example, you can go with flowers or acorns for fall. You can even use tiny little pumpkins if you have such stamps and cutouts to make a wreath for Halloween. So many different ways that you can dress it up. Now, since I'm going for a traditional card theme today, I'm going to turn this card into a vintage looking one. So that's why I grabbed my Distress Oxide ink, and this is Vintage Photo. I'm using craft cardstock here, and I'm going all around the edges. And I'm going to ink up the edges of that deep red cardstock, as well as add a touch of a Vintage Photo all around my wreath. So this way I have the same color on all my elements of this card, and this way I bring everything together. I will use my Nouveau Deluxe glue at the back of the craft panel and stick it on top of my red. And I always like to have a frame on my cards. I feel like it makes my card look more professional and more finished. And then I'm going to stick down my wreath by adding some foam squares at the back. The sentiment is from the classic holiday words. I used the Be Merry one and I didn't cut out the outline, I'm only using the actual words, and I used the glitter cardstock to cut it out. Notice that I added some ribbon at the top, and you can also add a little bow if you like. Here are some close-up photos of this card. And let's move on to the second card for today. For this one I'm going to do some stamping. I'm using the Cozy Christmas Wishes, which is a big background stamp. I'm going to stamp that with embossing ink, and then I'm going to apply on top white embossing powder. Before doing any embossing, I always like to run my embossing pillow all over the cardstock just to remove static electricity. When you are doing such a big embossing project, you need to make sure that you will end up with good results. The fun part about this background stamp is that you can create instant cards, so it is great for mass producing. Play with different colors of embossing powder on different colors of cardstock, and you can have many similar cards that you can put together really quickly. Now for this card today I decided to do some coloring, and I'm going to use my Prismacolor pencils. I love how these write on Nina Craft cardstock. And I'm going to add a few shades of green on the leaves, as well as some red on the berries and the little birdie. All the images are very small, so it doesn't take a lot of time to color it in. And then I'm going to put my card together. As you can see, I made it a little bit narrower. And I have those two strips of glitter cardstock, which I'm going to stick underneath, making sure that I leave just a tiny bit coming through. Now this is a Christmas card and I always like to add some sparkle on them. And finally I'm going to stick this panel on my card base, which is made out of red cardstock. To finish it off I'm using my gold stickles and I'm going to add some dots here and there, just to add some extra sparkle. Moving on to the third card for today, and I'm using a rectangle die to create a little frame. For this card I'm going to do some stamping and playing with all the bits and pieces from the Sparkle with Magic stamp set. So I'm placing temporarily that red frame on top of my card base, so that I can easily arrange the stamps, decide where everything is going to go, and stamp with different colors. Again, I'm going with traditional colors, obviously, that's red and green. So I am just mixing and matching different elements from this stamp set to embellish my sentiment all around. And along with green and red, I'm also going to add some gold here. I'm trying to catch the light for you so you can see how sparkly this ink is. And I continue stamping different bits and pieces from this stamp set until I'm happy with how it looks. Now to put this card together I can easily stick the frame all around and finish. I decided to go a step further and turn this into a shaker card, just because you know that I absolutely love shaker cards. So here I am at the back of this frame sticking down my acetate. I'm going to add some foam tape all around as well. And I'm going to mix those two different confettis from Nouveau. The gold one is called Festival Gold Circles and the green one is called Olive Green Stars. These are not sequins, they are completely flat, so they move really easily inside that window. Finally, I'm going to take this card a step further and I'm going to stick a thinner frame around the red one. I feel like by adding this thin green frame, it's more pleasing to the eye and it matches the greens inside the shaker card. So here are some close-up photos of this one. And let's move on to the final card for today. I'm using the wreath from the Season's Greetings stamp set. I'm going to stamp that with embossing ink on green cardstock and I'm going to emboss it with white embossing powder. Of course you can stamp the wreath and color it in with your favorite medium. I'm showing you a quicker way to use it, which is actually the way to go if you want to mass produce cards for Christmas. Now I have a dark green panel and I am placing the wreath on top so that I can measure about where about I need to stamp my sentiment. The sentiment comes from the same stamp set as the wreath and it reads Season's Greetings. I'm going to stamp that with embossing ink and emboss it with white embossing powder again. And I also did the same thing for the bow. Now I have all the elements ready to go. I'm going to stick the green panel on top of a red panel so I get a red frame all around. I'm going to stick the wreath on top and I have foam squares at the back. And finally I'm going to stick down the little bow. For that I'm using glue at the back. It is a very traditional looking Christmas card and it is not difficult to mass produce, especially if you do all the die cutting in the beginning and then put your card together. Now I am using my Nouveau Drops to add some dots here and there. Here are some close-up photos on the last card for today. And let's take a quick look on all the four cards that I made for today, showcasing products from the latest release by Pinkfresh Studios. I hope you had fun, that you got inspired. Down below in the description area you will find links to everything I used for making these cards. Don't forget to like and subscribe, as well as leave me a comment and let me know which one of those four cards was your favorite. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I'll see you all next time.